it's time to choose. Click on a creature with the action button to highlight him. He's gonna go for the lion. Oh, I know it. If you're sure, click the action button again on him. Oh, great choice, boss. So, boss, you've been asleep a long time. Do you need the refresher about how to move like a god? Use the action button on this scroll to find out how to move and look around.
Click the action button on this scroll to skip tutorials.
You will miss out on tribute if you skip it, though. This is a gold scroll. These lead you through the story.
Silver scrolls lead to quests in the world.
Bronze scrolls are tutorials, which can teach you so much. Are you sure you wish to leave the land?
Click again to confirm. Oh yeah, they didn't expect that. Split one, villager.
Now you've had a taste of your powers, we're ready to visit our mighty Greek capital.
Yeah, full of people that worship us.
Please hear us. Listen. Please help us.
Can you hear that?
We pray.
That's a pure prayer.
Hear our prayer.
It sounds like something terrible has happened.
Oh, mighty one, please heed our call in this hour of need. Our armies are crushed. What's left of us hides in this city from the brutal Aztecs. And now they are at our walls. I implore you, please help us.
Oh my! It's a huge Aztec army! They're invading!
Our city is under siege. The Aztecs have killed nearly all our troops. We're all going to die.
Aztec warriors have scaled the wall. They're firing down on your villages.
Pick up the...
You've got a villager, boss!
Yes! You put him down in the right place! People are trapped by the burning buildings. Grab them and drop them in the portal. That villager is now safe. Well done.
What's happening? What's that rumble?
That creature seems to be performing some strange ritual! He summoned a volcano!
But how?
I don't know, but we best save as many villages as we can and get out of here! What are these crazed Aztecs doing?
They crushed our lodges with barrels. We need revenge.
Look, there are some more barrels on the slope.
Pull the guard fence away. The barrels will roll towards those invading Aztec scum.
Look, leader, we can set these bales of hay on fire and roll them down to deal with the platoons down there.
Pick up the flaming stick and hold it over the hay bales.
Oh no, another volcano. We can't save any more people.
Done all we can here, leader. We have lots of followers, and we've escaped from the Aztecs.
Now, we gotta get ourselves powerful and take the fight back to the Aztec scum. But first, we'll have to conquer the Norse.
Or free them to join us, of course. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. To the Norse land!
Look! Here are the people we saved! They're exiting the portal! Wonderful!
Yeah! These guys made it, but think of how many got toasted! Anyway, where are we?
This looks like an old Greek settlement. We can re-establish ourselves here. It looks so peaceful here. With no Aztecs, it's the perfect place to build up and get more followers. There is already a town center, a storehouse, and a field which we can use. The green ring, you see, is the extent of your influence. You can only do things within this ring.
You can extend the green influence ring by placing more buildings and having more people.
When you're ready to learn how to feed your people, click on the gold scroll over the field, leader. Your villagers are going to need food very soon, leader. Move your hand over this field, then click and hold the action button to pick up the grain. When you've got 200 food in your hand, drop all through it into the storehouse.
There ain't enough food in there, boss! There ain't enough food in there, boss!
Now, put food in the storehouse.
There ain't enough food in there, boss! There ain't enough food in there, boss!
Now, click and hold the action button to pick up the grain. Drop the food into the storehouse. We now have enough food.
We need to get our people working if we want to rebuild, boss.
Villagers can be turned into disciples who will work at the job you assign them. Pick up a villager, then put them down on a field. Now place the villager down over the field.
Yeah, looks like your new disciple has started to work the field.
Another two farmers should satisfy the village's food requirements for now.
Those farmers can handle that small field with no problem, boss. We need wood if our villages are to build and our town expand. Grab and pull a tree out of the ground and drop it into the storehouse. Now put it in the storehouse. There ain't enough wood. Drop in another tree. Now put it in the storehouse.
We could really do with some discipled foresters to collect wood for us. Pick up a villager and drop them next to a tree to make them a discipled forester. Make a total of 3 foresters.
Now, place the villager next to a tree. We got some nifty forest thing going on, boss.
The statues on your town center represent your town's desires. This shows what your people would like to build next. Keeping your people happy is important, and they will let you know if they desire a building type. See how the statue is carrying grain? That represents the people's desires for food. If they need ore or wood, they will let you know. Keep an eye on the statue, as it will change.
This plinth's height represents how good or evil you are. From its top, a flame or a fountain will spring as you perform evil or good acts. The whole city will shift to show you if you are good or evil.
This statue lets you know your people's desires. Watch the height of the statue. The higher it is, the more they need their desire. This scroll shows the impressiveness of your city, its population and happiness. There is plenty of other useful information about your growing metropolis. Refer to it often. Hold your hand over the statues and leave it there to get more detail. Your people desire houses. Move your hand over the rotating building, then click and hold the action button to drag it off.
We'll need the right buildings and food if we're gonna support a powerful army.
That's right. Keep going.
We can speed it up by picking up a tree and dropping it on the building.
You can also drag a building blueprint off an existing house. Move your hand over the existing house. Hold down the action button and drag to get the blueprint. If you want to cancel an action and empty your hand, simply shake it briskly left and right.
Disciple Builder. Disciple Builder. Disciple Builder.
Keep going.
Disciple Builder. Disciple Builder.
Drop a tree onto the building foundation. Thank you.
Now, drop the tree over the house foundation.
See the pile of wood there? Your villagers will use that to build the house with. No, that's not right. The green ring, you see, is the extent of your influence. You've created a number of disciples, so why not create some more? Keep going.
Disciple Builder.
The house is finished, and look how delighted the villagers are. You can also help to build buildings yourself. This is God building. Yes, you do it by picking up resources the building needs. Then hold your hand over the building and press and hold the action button. This is very useful, but you do lose some of the resource in the process. That's not right. The green ring, you see, is the extent of your influence. No, that's not right. The green ring, you see, is the extent of your influence. Keep going. Enough houses for now. We must get the people to multiply. Oh dear, it's embarrassing talking about this.
No, it ain't. He's talking about breeding. Breeding, boss. You hear me, goody?
We need 3 breeder disciples to satisfy the village's needs. Drop a man or woman from your hand next to one of the opposite sex. Disciple breeders will continue forever. You need to create a disciple breeder. Look at that town. It's not dissimilar from ours. You need to create a disciple breeder. Excellent. We need two more to satisfy the village's needs. Marvelous. You've now created enough breeders. Any disciple will carry on doing that one job forever unless you give them another job. What we need to do is increase our population. Now we've got some breeders, it should be easy to get 75 villagers.
Disciple breeder. Disciple breeder.
Click the gold scroll when you are ready to learn about the toolbar. Right, let's open the toolbar. See, there is a flag at the bottom left of the screen. All you need to do to open it is...
Hey, what's that?
That is the toolbar. Good. Now click again to close it. Open it up again. The toolbar holds a series of menus. These tabs are used to navigate the different menus. The tab currently selected is the construction tab. So the menu shown is the construction menu. Each menu is divided into sub-menus. We are going to show you how to access some advanced features. Press F4 to bring up the tribute menu.
This is the coolest part of the menu.
The tribute is like a form of currency. You can spend it on whatever you like, including new buildings. You can improve your godly powers and add constructions or features to your town. You earn tribute by finishing challenges and doing other impressive things. We have plenty of tribute at the moment. Enough to buy a temple. You can now build a temple. This is a good thing, with a capital G. Your town's impressiveness will increase. Select the temple from the construction menu, then place it down in your town. Some buildings require ore to be built. There are two sources of ore. The first is the ore mine, an ore deposit in the ground that can be mined by your villagers. There are also ore rocks.
The villagers can mine these, but to save time, you can add them to your storehouse yourself.
Yes, a temple adds a lot of impressiveness to your town. No, that's not right. The green ring you see is the extent of your influence.
boss, let's speed things up by using God building. Pick up some wood or ore.
Hold your hand over the temple and hold the action button to help construct the building.